move that data into. So you see significant differences in block storage and data transfer. Let's look at object storage. S3 is without a doubt the largest and most popular object store for unstructured data. And in the nearly 13 years that we've been operating S3 with exabytes of data, many exabytes of data, it's also become the clear number one choice for data lakes. We have over 10,000 data lakes being run on top of S3. And there's a few reasons for it. First is, it's the most secure object store. It's the only object store that allows you to be able to audit every access to an object, who did it, where they did it from, what they tried to do. It's the only one that gives you a daily report of all your objects, so you can check out things like, are all my objects encrypted? It's the only one that allows you to block public access to all of your buckets or at an account level with S3 block public access we launched a couple weeks ago. It's also the only one that has a capability like MACI that allows you to look at sensitive data and if there are any anomalies in the access pattern. So it's not only more secure, it's also the most operationally performant object store. And there's several things we do to make that so, but I'll mention a couple right now. First, we replicate all your objects across multiple availability zones, typically at least three. And those availability zones are separated by several miles. Usually it's several, no more than 100. Now this is an important point because it means that you get fault tolerance, but you can use those that data in those applications because the latency is low enough, given how far apart they are, that you can actually make the application work for end users. Now if you compare that to what other providers do, either they don't really have multiple availability zones and regions and are scrambling really quickly to try and build that construct, or those that do typically have those availability zones in the same building or next door to each other or across the street. And that means that if there's some kind of event in a building or on a street that blows up, sometimes literally, your entire durability and availability story. So S3, a very different story there. Also, we have a lot of customers who want to replicate objects across regions. And S3 is the only object store that allows you to do cross-region replication without having to create a separate storage class and to be able to pick whichever region you want and as many as you want. So you get a lot more cross-region replication in S3. The third thing is that S3 gives you much more comprehensive flexibility in being able to operate at an object level. And it turns out when you get into the details of managing your objects, having to manage at such a high level like the bucket level isn't super useful. And so S3 allows you to do things like replicating objects by tag or lifecycle tiering by tag or setting access control policies by object or retention policies by object. And then just a couple days ago, we launched S3 batch operations, which allows you to take all these operations and actions against objects, but across your thousands and millions and billions of objects in a much easier way through these APIs, much faster than you ever could do before. And again, these are all capabilities you'll only find in S3. And then most customers are continually looking to try to find ways to save money on storage. And nobody gives you more ways to save money on an object store than S3. And we have a number of storage classes. We have S3 Standard, which we've had since the start, and S3 Standard and Frequent Access for objects that are accessed less frequently. And for customers who are willing to trade a little bit of durability for lower cost, they can, and are willing to store it in a single availability zone, we have S3 One Zone IA. For archival and backup, we have Glacier. Now, a couple days ago, we launched a brand new storage class called Intelligent Tiering, S3 Intelligent Tiering. And this is the world's first machine learning-driven object storage class in the cloud that automatically saves you money. And what it does is it actually uses the 13 years of experience we've had with the trillions and trillions of objects and the various access patterns and has built a model and then looks at your own unique access patterns for each of those objects. And when it looks like you should actually move that to a colder tier, it automatically does that and saves you the money. And when it looks like it's being accessed more frequently, it moves it to the warmer tier. So this is significant savings for you where you don't have to do anything when you put objects in the intelligent tiering class. Now, if you don't want to rely on intelligent tiering and machine learning, we also have S3 storage class analytics, which is a unique capability that only we have, that shows you various patterns in your objects and makes recommendations on where to life cycle Tira. Now, we have a lot of storage classes, but we're not close to being done. And let me give you an example.